Access Fort Wayne offers reflections of our community. Production facilities provided by Access Fort Wayne are a service of the Allen County Public Library. The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting organizations. For more information about creating your own television program with Access Fort Wayne, call 421-1250.
This is Patty Hunter, and this is my show, Patty's Page. Today, my special guest is Steve D. Manning. Hello, dear.
Hey, how you doing, Patty?
It's good to see you. About time I had you
Likewise.
On my show.
Yeah.
It's been 4 years since I actually been in production as a producer and host.
Okay.
At Access Fort Wayne here in Fort Wayne.
Great.
So I understand that you had worked here.
Yes, I worked here for 11 years.
Yeah.
Started back in 1988 and worked until 2001. And I was a program director here.
Oh.
Prior to that, I was a volunteer.
Oh.
So, yes, my roots are in public access television.
So, tell me about yourself. Were you from here?
I'm from Fort Wayne. I graduated from Elmhurst High School back in 1976. Lived in an interesting neighborhood in Fort Wayne on Wallace Street. It's kind of an industrial area right now.
Yeah.
But back then, on Wallace Street, there was right down the street from us the Seifert's Potato Chips factory.
That must have
so
been.
When we walked out our back door or front door, we would have that flavor or the savory smell of Seifert's Potato Chips.
Is it still here?
It's no, Seifert has moved away. But also on that street we had a fire station, and it's interesting.
It was interesting.
Yes.
All that fire trucks going back and forth and all that.
Yes.
Oh, that must have been noisy.
So I grew up in Fort Wayne.
But they're there for a reason.
Yes.
I'm glad we have the fire people and the ambulance and police. Without them, we would not be safe.
You're absolutely right.
That's right. You were a welfare caseworker?
I was, and I was. I worked as a caseworker for only a short period of time, and that was prior to my coming to. Back then, it was to Access Fort Wayne, but worked as a case manager actually for less than a year, and things didn't work out well. And I'm so happy.
Didn't
because I wouldn't have. I don't think I would have been on the path of. Working back in television, radio, where, you know, that's my passion, radio, television, and film. So,
did you take school, go to graduate school to learn broadcasting or journalism? Or?
Well, I have a bachelor's degree in radio, television, and film from IU Bloomington.
Ah.
And I just finished my master's degree in educational studies at IPFW on the Indiana University side, of course. So,
of course.
Yeah. Studied radio, TV, film. I have the privilege and honor actually of working in all those areas right now. I work as a public relations person for WFCV Radio.
What's that?
Which is a Christian
station.
Bot? It's BOT.
BOT Radio.
It's BOT Radio Network.
That's cool.
We have over 90 radio stations in our network, and I do public relations whenever we sponsor a concert or a Christian event. I'm the one that goes out, sets up the table and the banners, and go on stage and welcome the folks to the event. So that's a neat gig.
You're like an MC. Yes.
Oh. So I've been working for BOT Radio Network for 9 years now.
And he's aging himself.
Yes.
He's aging himself.
So I have no problem at all with my age. But yeah, now I'm also working full-time as the CEO of Manning Video Productions, LLC.
Mm-hmm.
And
How long has that been?
Actually, technically, it's been going over 2 years, but just in the past 6 months, I got everything legit. You know, it became a corporation, LLC, and my office and studio is located out in Innovation Park.
Innovation Park,
Northeast Indiana Innovation Center, right there on the corner of Stillhorn and St. Joe.
That's near IPFW.
Mm-hmm.
Do you work there?
It's right across the way from IPFW.
Do you do any volunteering or anything like that at IPFW?
I don't, no. I'm working actually an average of 70 hours.
70 hours?
With my job, with actually my
getting
my business,
sleep?
I'm sorry. I do.
I like this. So you are a plasma giver. You give blood. That's not really blood.
That was as a college student. I don't even know how you guys got that.
I have
that
my
was
ways.
When I was a poor college student and needed extra money.
Oh.
And a lot of people do that.
I know someone
as college
doing
students.
That.
Yeah. So back in the it was the mid 1970s.
Yeah.
They had a plasma unit there close to campus, and I would donate plasma for our money.
You're still here, so they must have left some. Sorry. So, did you work at a coffee house?
I did not work at a coffee house.
Mm. Okay, I'm sorry, I thought you did. Carriage House, that's it.
Carriage House is an awesome place, has been very, very instrumental in my life since 2001. I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder way back in 2001.
I'm bipolar.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay. But Carriage House was very instrumental in my successful recovery. Been a member of the clubhouse since 2001. The clubhouse movement is quite different from the medical model. It's a model that focuses on a person's strengths, talents, and abilities rather than the illness. Yeah. So what it is Carriage House, and our clubhouse is located on Lake Avenue, 3327 Lake. It's organized in what is called a work order day. From 8 to 5, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Members come, they participate in keeping the house going.
Yeah.
So that's one of
nice.
The primary aspects of Clubhouse. But also, Clubhouse focuses on encouraging its members to go back to school or go back to work.
Prepare them.
Yes.
Go back to work.
Yes, and they're not forced to go back to school or to work or to go to school or work
just
for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
However, there's a strong encouragement, and that's one of the primary aspects of Clubhouse, of helping members get back into the workforce and helping members return to school. I was in really bad shape. I was in bad shape when after. I found out that I had bipolar disorder, but there was a time period when I was very suicidal.
Oh.
There was a time period when I was homeless.
Oh.
Didn't have a job, didn't have a place to live. But after becoming a member of the Carriage House, my life began to change drastically.
They do help.
Yes.
I understand that.
So there was a very drastic and successful rehabilitation. So much so that after becoming a member of the Carriage House, I was instrumental in starting an in-house video production studio.
Yeah, I understand you did that. Yeah.
Yeah, so that
I'm
actually...
still doing that?
I am not, primarily because I'm involved with my business. But that video department, which we call CHAV, Carriage House Audio Visual, continues because other members got involved.
Yeah.
We were able to train several members and several staff members to continue CHAV, which is a neat thing. It's good to look at something that you started and see that it's continuing. But that was the primary thing in my life that caused the change, and it was the primary thing that was instrumental in my starting Manning Video Productions LLC.
That's beautiful. How where do you think you're going with this video production? What do you normally do? Who are your clients?
Right now I have about 15 projects that I'm working on.
You're the CEO,
all at different levels. It's at a point where I'm hiring independent producers, freelance producers, and I plan to grow the business as much as I can, and also to I plan to travel to several cities to hire producers in those cities, primarily New York, Chicago.
You've been to New York quite often.
Yes, I do travel to New York quite often. But I plan to grow it, and for it to continue to be successful. It's fun, it's challenging, it's exciting to see it grow, and it's a lot of hard work, but it's well worth it.
The producers that you are looking for, what are the credentials you need?
Well, I'm looking for folks with, number one, a bachelor's degree in radio, television, and film.
Yeah.
I'm looking for folks who have extensive experience in producing a wide range of projects. Manning Video Productions produces high-end TV commercials, music videos, weddings, promotional videos, documentaries, and probably within another year we'll be producing feature motion pictures. So I'm looking for someone who can take a client and take a project from beginning to end without whole lot of my hands on. Someone asked me the other day if I would train if I'm training new people, and I don't have time to do that.
Unless you had assistant doing that or something like that, you wouldn't.
Pardon?
Would you have an assistant doing that if you think it's no.
Probably not.
Okay. Now, you're on the National Board of Directors. What board?
I'm on the Board of Directors for Clubhouse International. And Clubhouse International is the organization that oversees all the clubhouses in the world. There are about 340 clubhouses, similar to the one at Carriage House, across our country and around the world at different places in the world, in Germany, Australia, China, South Africa. I sit on the board. So I travel to New York often. I'll be going in 7 days. It's neat to go to New York because there's so much to do there, so much to see there.
It's so busy.
Huge place. I think in the past 2 years I've gone about 6 or 7 times. Every time I go, I enjoy it. But Clubhouse International makes sure that every clubhouse is trained and they get the same type of training. There's a specific way to do clubhouse, and we take clubhouse members, clubhouse through a certification process. So what we do is we train new clubhouses, then eventually we certify them if they meet all the requirements, and then we continue to keep up with them to make sure that they're running their clubhouses in the way that they should.
So they're staffed, every one of those clubs?
Yes, they're staffed.
They're
different sized clubhouses, and yes, they do have volunteers, and the volunteers are actually the members.
Yeah.
So, when you go to a clubhouse, be prepared to be asked to do a task, but you're not forced to do a task. Mm-hmm. Everything's voluntary.
They encourage you.
Mm-hmm, they encourage you. And it's a very vibrant atmosphere when you walk into a clubhouse. Another thing you will not be able to tell, for the most part, a member from a staff. And at medical facilities, they called them consumers or clients. But the whole thing with Clubhouse is members are made to feel that they own the Clubhouse. Members even participate in the hiring of new staff.
Okay.
So it's a wonderful organization. Did a great job in my successful rehabilitation. I don't think I would be sitting
without,
here today.
Without Carriage House, you have anything to do with NAMI?
I don't know. At one time, I know about NAMI, and I know the folks who are involved with NAMI locally. I've played in their golf tournaments, but I'm not real involved with NAMI. But NAMI in Fort Wayne was very instrumental in getting the Carriage House started. Had it not been for the local NAMI and their members, our Carriage House Clubhouse would probably not exist the way it is today.
And they wouldn't be helping people like us.
Right, right.
Yeah. Now, you have a clip.
Time to set up the clip. Okay.
Time to set up the clip.
I do several speaking engagements, speak to large and small organizations. And several months ago, I was a keynote speaker at the Love Church banquet, our annual banquet. And they asked me to put together a video and to ask a few people who know about me to speak on my behalf on my rehabilitation, and also to include in this video some pieces of my work. So that's what I've done with this, is I've asked some people to speak on my behalf, and then I put three spots that I've been in. Mm-hmm. One is a motion picture called Out of Time.
Mm-hmm. What's that all about?
It's a paranormal Christian video, which in the movie I played the supervisor of a police department. The second clip that you'll see is a television commercial, which is kind of zany, that for Channel
like
15.
Like you.
For Channel 15, and it was fun to be in this. I played Judge Joe Brown in this commercial. And then the last motion picture was produced by George Johnson. It was called Homeless for the Holidays. I was on tech for this motion picture, but they also had me play a character in the movie. So, without further ado, I guess the introduction.
I guess we can play it now. Thank you.
I've known Steve for the better part of 30 years, but we're sitting on a porch that about 20 years ago, Steve walked on this porch and he was having tremendous mental and emotional struggles. And he really, really scared me because he didn't make any sense. And he was obviously going through a really, really tough time in his life. But for some reason, and we believe it's God, led Steve into Love Church. And what a blessing it's been to see how God has blessed Steve and used Steve.
Steven has quit listening to everybody in the world and started a very godly relationship to God that really gives all of his creative ability and talents the kind of strength and authority and confidence that they've always deserved. And been there, he just learned to think in a whole different way. He's really changed his life dramatically. And it's because he thinks as a confident, healthy, godly man.
He no longer has to worry about having depression in his past. His future looks bright. He's involved in so many projects, and he's really turned his life around, starting a business with video productions, and he's so good at it. He's just a great interviewer. Great editor, when doing videos. And it's amazing what he is today from what he's come from.
Person. As a writer, one of the things that Steve brings to the news that's unique is that he not only can tell you the facts, but he can give you the feeling behind it. He's got a great empathy for people, so not only is he telling you the facts of their story, he's telling you the emotion and the spirit behind it. As a video producer, I'm just blown away by his work. It's just outstanding. I've seen some of his music stuff and his new stuff, and they're all just, it's all great.
And as he has become more, I think, who he wants to be, and as he has tackled and surmounted all of the stuff that challenges him in his life, it has been nothing but pure joy to walk with Stephen. And I look forward all the time to the next great thing that Stephen does, and I miss seeing Stephen every day, because he's my friend. And every day I feel warm and strong, because my friend Stephen's out there in the world, setting the world on fire.
Pierce, I'm an investigator, not a politician.
And I need to let this Justice Department debacle blow over. We can kill two birds with one stone.
I don't know what to say.
I suggest you say thanks. Listen, Jade, Rosenberg asked for my help, and as a Christian and as a professional, I need to give my very best, and you're it. Besides, it's a great opportunity for you to be on some cutting-edge research, so I'm not asking, I'm telling.
Pay attention!
This September, Judge Joe.
I thought that was my line.
The real people weren't available to shoot.
This is not my gavel.
Yeah, maybe he needs to go a little slower.
Every weekday at 3 p.m.
And I follow you at 3:30.
I don't even see this Dr. Oz on this list.
Who left this guy in my courtroom?
Which camera am I on?
Listen to me.
Where's that in the script?
You can never have enough props.
Who's lab coat?
It helps the audience understand.
When did
this start? Switching time.
When is it again? How do you expect me to remember that?
How long is this going to take?
How about we try it like this?
The Real Deal with Real Stories. Judge Jill at 3, Judge Judy at 3:30, and Dr. Oz moves to 4. Then, don't miss Fort Wayne's only Emmy Award-winning news coverage on News Channel 15's First at 5. Weekdays beginning September 12th on Wayne TV.
Coverage you can count on.
Then, one day, this chapter did something that every chapter and every book must eventually do. It came to an end.
Excuse me, can you tell me where I might find Jack Baker?
Hey, Jack!
I got it!
Hey, I'll be back, kids, okay?
Jack Baker?
Yeah?
Rod Stevenson, Puries.
Rod Stevenson? Hi. What brings you out here?
You do, actually. We know about what happened at Smith Anderson, and we know that it wasn't your fault. There aren't many people who would be willing to fall on their own sword to save their coworkers' jobs, especially in this economy. Everybody's looking out for themselves. You're a rare find, Jack, and you're exactly the kind of person that Puries views as upper management material. We've always admired your work, and we want you to come on board as our director of marketing. We'll beat anything Smith Anderson was paying you, and we offer plenty of room for growth.
How did you ever find us?
We received a call from Carl Ferguson's former assistant, Miranda. She left the company when she found out what they had done to you. She works for us now, and she told us we could find you here. We want you on our team, Jack. What do you say?
I understand you do videos for singers.
Yes.
Ah. Mimi Burns?
Well, Mimi Burns and several other singers, but we did a great music video for Mimi Burns, and we produced, when I say we, I mean John Gillespie and I co-produced a music video for Mimi Burns, and the title of the song was Farewell Dear Aaron, and you can see that music video on YouTube. Just go to YouTube, then type in Farewell, F-A-R-E-W-E-L-L, Dear, D-E-A-R, Aaron, E-R-I-N. We're so excited about this music video because it turned out great. We shot it at the Dunes last summer, and again, it features Mimi Burns, Styler, and he's also called Steve Tyler, right? Steve Tyler. He plays the guitar in the video, and then the first chair of the Fort Wayne Philharmonic, Derek Rees, plays the violin. So it's the three of them in this music video, and you've got to see it. You absolutely have to see it because it's awesome. So yeah, people out there, go to that music video whenever you can. We're very proud of it. It's a cool video. It shows the quality of the work that Manning Video Productions does.
I was wondering, it's almost the end of the show now, so would you like to come back as a guest?
Sure. I'll come back anytime you want me to come back.
Be a co-host or a co-host, my guest.
That'd be great. I'd love to. And thanks so much for having me as a guest this time.
Oh, well, you know, you're a joy to have. You've been my friend for 7 years now.
Yes.
4 or 5 years? 5 years?
I don't know the exact time, but... It's been an honor being your friend.
Okay, well, I gotta go.
All right.
This is Patty Hunter of Patty's Page, and this is the man. Have a great day. See you next week.
The lighthouse, I can show it away. Let me be your shining light.